Eric, what do you do for a living? What gets you up in the morning? What's your passion?
Well, basically, I do conservation work, but my conservation work is not really with regards to buildings or architecture. It's more of trying to call out and document all these resources, heritage resources, memories of the people. So memories of, well, the landscape, memories about buildings, structures, monuments, memories of the traditions.
And it's important to map all of this. If we don't map them, just like in my field, we don't. We don't document buildings and sites. The danger is that these things will just be demolished and they will disappear.
Yes, that's true. And I'm sure you've seen how cities have transformed overnight.
We're losing one heritage building every month. And that's just in Metro Manila alone.
Well, the danger there is that you lose your mind map. Mm-hmm. Sometimes you get disoriented. So the moment you lose many of these, the structures, the practices.
The sounds,
even. The sounds, no? The configuration of the corners, no, even the scaling.
Yes.
The scaling of the street, the proportions.
Naiba.
It has a different feel already. Mm.
Again, going back to why we need to document and to map all of these things is we need to be able to give value to them. Mm-hmm. And then,
that's true.
If we do have to make over these places because population are expanding, you have to be able to contain more people, you have to build new buildings, they still have to have a connection to that sense of place. Uh-huh. I think that's the danger in my line of work, which is physical design of structures, cities, and landscapes.
How do you manage that, Paulo? Particularly in your field, no? The physicality, the scaling of all these sites.
One of the deficiencies of design in a hurry, because a lot of these designs are done in a hurry, is that we have a very weak foundation for a lot of the designs we have to churn out because of pressures from clients. Mm-hmm. The ideal situation will be to rely on base work done by people like yourself. We really need to shore up that front end of the work. So we should not start until you guys have done the mapping and we have ourselves appreciated the findings that you've gathered.
The idea of mapping now has really evolved in terms of before when we did mapping, the data itself was, that's the end point. But now it has reached different trajectories. For example, mapping now is being used for tourism. So whenever they would come up with new spills for their site, for their destinations, we always tell them, try to call out new stories. If you're going to put together a nice story that's really your own, that is a big come on for your tourism.
I mean, it can be, it's more fun everywhere.
Yes.
I'm sure people are tired of going to a place and having the same food.
Ah, yes.
Sometimes
the same
you go
zip
to,
line, yes. The same.
the zip you know, line.
It's, everybody has the zip line now. So when the river crew started in Bohol, everybody had river cruises.
I mean, there's nothing wrong with river cruises per se, but if they start to imitate everything that's on the cruise, the
music, the band,
strumming,
the food.
Yes. Really, that's because they haven't mapped enough or even themselves appreciated what they have. A lot of the people, I think, don't value their own culture as much as they look up to Manila. Mm-hmm. And so they tend to parrot what Manila has done or what other people have done instead of understanding that what they have is really what makes them unique.
Even if you say, okay, we'll go up north, no? And all these Region 1 provinces would offer you all this abel. But you'll be surprised. It differs, no?
From the patterns,
the color,
textures.
Even the color combination, it's very different.
I think architects and physical designers can take a cue from that because what's happening in the Philippines is that a lot of the designs are becoming already default designs and there's nothing specific to the place or to the culture that's reflected in, say, even if you go to a hotel, you don't know where you are.
Oh,
you don't know that you're in Batangas, you don't know that you're in Bohol, because there's nothing to define that space as specific to that area. I mean, some of the styles are global in their outlook. But it doesn't mean that it cannot be local in the experience of the spaces inside those buildings. Mm-hmm. And here's our wine.
Oh, thank you very much.
Maybe we should toast to culture first. Here's to culture.
Here's to culture. Here's to heritage.
Going back to the realities, and you were saying the angle of tourism, why would people visit a place if it's just the same as Manila or anywhere
else? Oh, yes.
Mm-hmm. So we must learn the lessons from our neighbors to base our tourism on cultural specificity and ensure that when they visit, it's something unique.
It's a long struggle. Internationally, so many heritage concerns surfaced. You know, of course, from the bombing of Palmyra and Aleppo down to the World Heritage sites being destroyed.
On the physical side, there are a lot of programs already to digitally scan the structures themselves using new technology that conserves the data of,
the building itself. The bones of the building.
In 3D. So, because we do not have the funds to conserve all of the buildings, and earthquakes happen left and right, we may lose, as Bohol has, a lot of these churches. So until such time as government sees it fit to support conservation of these structures, we have to document that. I think it can be done hand in hand with cultural mapping, the physical mapping of a place. Well, without our heritage, we're nothing. The reason you stay in a place is because you love it. The only reason you love a place is because you love its culture. And you must remember, you are part of that culture. If you don't enjoy your own culture, and that starts from appreciating your culture and the history behind it, then why stay?
Well, primarily for me, I'm into conservation because, well, I love culture. Culture is life. And if you're into heritage, cultural heritage particularly, you know that your lifetime is extended. You touch on memory, you touch on the present, you touch on continuity. So you live a life longer than your lifetime. You may only have this frame, no, this particular period, but you're already influencing the past up to the future. So I always feel that it's a very noble work because you always make sure that first you transform, you touch lives, no? And when you do something, it has to be of very good quality. No, there's that level of excellence always. You wouldn't like to shortchange people because you'll be touching lives. The moment you touch their lives, that will be part of their memory. You wouldn't like to have a city or a country with amnesia. No, that's a total loss. Yeah. So this one is really fortifying, instilling, and impressing to every generation that this is who you are, this is where you come from, this is where you die. No, you'll be dying very proud of who you are. For me, that's very fulfilling. That's very fulfilling. No, every day you do that, you get excited because no two projects are the same.
Yes.
You always have to understand them from the bottom. And then how you transform, you interpret, and eventually you see the transformation.
I think Eric touched on the very essential reason why we do the work, because it's noble work.
It's noble work.
And the noble work ensures that we ennoble the Filipino. And that's the best goal. Very good.
Very good.